Hi, welcome to PN Recapped Mystery. Today we explain the movie from 2005 called Idiocracy. Beware of spoilers, watch out and take care, and I hope you enjoy the video. The narrator explains that regular determination is unconcerned with intelligence, so that in a society where knowledge is reliably spoiled, inept, flighty individuals effectively outbreed the intelligent, making, throughout the span of 5 centuries, an irremediably faint and sexually motivated dystopia. Segment prevalence leans toward those most outlandish over advanced society. Thus, the offspring of the informed elites are suffocated in an ocean of indiscriminate, unskilled, common companions. In 2005, Corporal Joe Bowers, 1A, U.S. Army custodian charted as the Army's generally normal trooper, and Rita, a whore unnerved by her pimp, upgrade, are guinea pigs in confidential, year-long, military hibernation project. They are fixed in their hibernation chambers, to be stirred a year later. However, the experiment is failed to awaken a year later when the official in control, Lieutenant Colonel Collins, is arrested for having begun his own prostitution ring under the tutelage of Upgrade. The Army base is destroyed, and a Fuddruckers is built on the site. 500 years later, their hibernation chambers are jostled open in the great garbage avalanche of 2505, restoring the two of them. Joe collides into the house of Frida Pendejo, a typical, simpleton resident of the American future, whose residence is brimming with lousy nourishment with a noticeable, giant TV screen that is covered with adverts. His name, Frida Pendejo, is an erratic blend of a product mascot and a Spanish slang word insult. Frito is watching out. My Balls, a well-known TV program that experiences its name with almost no imaginative exertion. Joe is bewildered and incapable to practice the prudence important to permit Frito to watch his program. Subsequently, Joe is thrown out the window his container recently broke. Joe coincidentally finds an emergency clinic, where slacker Dr. Lexus, MD, analyzes him as essentially retarded and screwed up. Dr. Lexus alarms on finding that Joe has no barcode tattoo to his left wrist, thus can't be scanned for automatic debit payment. Having seen that the date of a magazine he finds on the doctor's desk has a similar date shown on his bill, Joe at last grasps that 500 years have passed since the Army placed him in stasis. He is alarmed by the sights of the collapsing world, decaying buildings cabled to each other, mountains of garbage, a freeway that ends in a drop-off, etc., and escapes the hospital, just to be captured at a Carl's Jr. junk food vending booth for not paying his hospital bill and for not having a barcode tattoo. At trial, Joe's public defense lawyer is Frida Pendejo, Esquire, who idiotically helps convict him, referring to the prosecutor's demand that Joe is guilty and his own outrage at Joe for harming his home. Joe is detained, an inadequately planned ID tattoo machine renames Joe as not sure and barcode tattoos him all things considered. During a compulsory IQ test, Joe grasps just how stupid humanity has become. Effectively getting away from his faint jailers, Joe gets back to Frito's house, inquiring as to whether a time machine exists to assist him with getting back to the past, to 2005. Frito claims there is one, however consents to help solely after Joe guarantees him billions of dollars from a saving account that Joe will open in the past upon his return. Frito can't comprehend the idea of accruing funds, however trusts Joe that Frito will acquire $30 billion minus the $20 billion for costs, making $80 billion. On the way to the time machine, Joe and Frito track down Rita. She doesn't realize that she's been asleep for 500 years until Joe tells her. And surprisingly then, at that point, she expects Upgrade will track down her. Frito drives them to a city-sized Costco, where Joe is recaptured when he unintentionally permits his barcode to be scanned. Rather than jail, Joe is conveyed to the White House. President Dwayne Elizondo Mountain Dew Herbert Camacho has seen Joe's IQ test and recruits him as Secretary of the Interior to address the United States food and yield deficiencies, dust bowl, crippled economy, piles of trash, and related issues. The other cabinet members are parodies of contemporary lawmakers' nepotism, corporate reliability defilement, and over-accentuation on sex advance in political media inclusion. Joe discovers that water has been replaced with Brondo, the thirst mutilator, a beverage publicized as wealthy in electrolytes, for essentially every reason, including crop water system. The Brondo Corporation, with an end goal to help their own deals, had, previously, began a mission guaranteeing that water was just great for use and toilets. Over the long haul, the electrolytes in Brondo accumulated in the soil, killed the crops, and caused the food lack. After giving up on explaining to the cabinet that electrolytes are not conducive to plant life, Joe once again introduces of watering crops. Overnight, the Brondo Corporation's stock becomes useless, causing extraordinary joblessness without apparently advancing the harvest circumstance. The furious people revolt. Joe is made the substitute, and is condemned to a day of rehabilitation, an execution masked as a public destruction derby, charged as Monday night rehabilitation. In the meantime, Rito finds that the dirt has made harvests sprout in the fields. To save Joe, with Frito close behind, she payoffs a TV cameraman to show the growing harvests to the world. Prior to arriving at the harvest field, Frito and the cameraman are diverted by a deal at a Starbucks chain brothel franchise. Only after they squabble and battle carries out, Frito recollect his obligation and film the crop sprouts. President Camacho sees the flourishing new plants on the arena's extra-large TVs, and awards Joe an acquittal similarly as he is going to be burned with a flamethrower. At the festival, Joe chooses to remain and assist with fixing American human advancement. President Camacho names him Vice President of America. He likewise discovers that the time machine is only an event congregation ride, with an authentic topic, wherein Charlie Chaplin was head of the Nazi party who utilized dinosaurs to take up arms against the world, and the UN un-Nazied the world until the end of time. Joe serves a short term as vice president, then, is chosen as Camacho's replacement. Joe and Rita wed and have the world's three most astute children, while Frito Pendejo takes eight spouses and fathers 32 of the world's dumbest kids, repeating the prologue to the film. After the credits, a third hibernation case is shown opening, delivering a snappily dressed up grid into the world, who swaggers down the road, as a pimp is wont to do. To watch more explanations of these kinds of movies, click on the videos on your screen and don't forget to let me know how you feel about today's video in the comments down below. Kindly like the video and subscribe to my channel and press the bell icon so you don't miss any new videos. Thanks for watching.